fellow VR adventurers. Last week we went to VR Days, which is a 3-day conference and exhibition focused on everything VR, AR and MR related. It was in Amsterdam, so we were happy to be able to drive there because it was only 1 hour away, and instead of flying somewhere very far just to try out new VR technology. Well, not that that is a bad thing, of course, but it's a nice change. There was a lot to learn, see and try at VR Days, like Anti-Latency was there, Pico, Birdly, Tesla Suit, game developers. Unfortunately, we were only there for 1 day due to other work next to YouTube, so we could not talk to everyone and film everything. However, we did choose 3 companies that we found particularly interesting to tell you all about in this video. And we talked to the developers of those companies and we recorded that, so that will be coming up in this video. First up is SenseGlove, a force feedback system that enables the users to feel the shape and density of virtual objects. Secondly, we checked out the Tesla Suit, a full body haptic VR suit that lets you touch and feel in virtual reality. And we also checked out Magnus VR, which is a flexible haptic glove. These are technologies that will make being in virtual reality so much more immersive, and so in this video we can tell you how far that technology is right now. How close are we to the technology in Ready Player One? Now let's start with SenseGlove. All right, I'm here with Gijs den Butter, CEO of SenseGlove. I just tried it out too, and it was really amazing. Can you explain a little bit about your glove?
Yeah, so SenseGlove is a force and haptic feedback glove that enables you to touch digital objects. So for example, in virtual reality.
Okay, so how does it work exactly? What's the technique behind it?
Yeah, so the technology behind it is, it consists of like 2 technologies. So the first is the force feedback, so that's when you feel restricted when you're trying to grasp an object, or it gives you the squeeziness of, for example, the stress ball. And there's also vibro-tactile feedback in, so vibration motors that as soon as you're trying to put on a tool, you feel the tool vibrating if you pull the trigger, or if you pat the surface, you can distinguish different kind of surfaces between each other. So those are the 2 technologies inside the glove.
I think it's really incredible. I just tried it out and I actually tried grabbing a soft ball or something, and it felt really realistic, like I was really touching a soft ball. It's different than like a metal object, right? How did you guys distinguish those things?
Yeah, so we have sort of motors that can adjust to the material properties of it. So we can ramp up forces, we can ramp down forces, or we can immediately stop you, so there's like almost no latency on the actual force feedback that you feel. So well, when you're trying to grasp a metal object, we do like 100% force on your fingers, and when it's a more softer object, we gradually ramp it up.
Oh wow, that's an awesome technique. So you guys, we were talking about this before, you guys are more into the B2B market, right?
Yeah, so currently most of the clients that we have are like business to business clients who do like virtual reality training for assembly tasks in automotive environments, or also companies that want to create great experiences. So for example, one of our clients made an experience where you could really feel how it is to have MS, so multiple sclerosis, I think is the name of the disease itself. So those are like more the applications where we're currently looking into. Has also something to do with the price. The set of the gloves is now currently sold for 2,000 euros. So it's not really affordable for a gaming perspective, but hopefully one day we'll get there as well.
Yeah, are you guys thinking about doing consumer market too?
Yeah, so we're thinking about it, but it's not really on our roadmap yet.
Okay, because it will be really amazing, I think.
Yeah, and we also need to like integrate with games. We need to have like bigger game developers that actually are willing to integrate the glove into such environments. And I think also because the glove is quite bulky now, we have also the potential to make it smaller, to make it really inside a glove look like. So we really need to take these steps before looking into consumer markets.
Okay, because you were also talking about the possibility of making it wireless too, right?
Yeah, so currently because of the Ferret, it's connected to the computer directly via USB wire. We are working on a wireless version as well that we release somewhere in the end of this year.
Okay, so right now only cabled.
Yeah, so our customers use it now cabled. We also are already pre-ordering the wireless kits, and at our office you can do it wireless, then we kind of position the tracker from the hand, from the glove until the wrist, and underneath the wrist there is a small battery, and then you connect it with a small cable to the wristband in the sense.
And you said it was a Bluetooth connection, right?
It is a Bluetooth connection in there, yeah.
All right. Thank you a lot for your answers. It was really, really interesting.
Really nice to meet you, and have fun with the video.
Thank you.
So that was the Sense Glove. My first thoughts after trying it out was, whoa, this is awesome technology, since I could actually feel the difference between a soft stress ball and a metal object virtually. I mean, that's just insane. Cherry did say that she sometimes didn't find the glove comfortable though, since it holds back your fingers, and sometimes when you lose tracking or accidentally touch a virtual object, the glove would activate and not allow you to freely move your fingers. That was uncomfortable sometimes. It is also very bulky and doesn't seem like a great product to use for gaming yet. But as said in the interview, this product is more for businesses that make particular teaching applications using this device. I do think it will take a while before a product like this comes to the consumer or gaming market, since the price is pretty steep, and also it just needs to be wireless and less bulky for it to work without the hassle at home. Overall, I do think it is amazing though that we are as far as they are right now with the technology. So, I think the only way is up, right? And now let's move on to the Tesla suit. So for this one, we unfortunately could not get an interview with someone. So I'm going to try and recap what we tried and saw over there as good as possible. When we got there, they only had male-sized tops. So I did not try the full body suit, just the upper part. It did not fit me all the way, but they could roll up my sleeve over here to make it fit. I had to take off all my clothing underneath, since they said that would make me feel the most. It was a tight fit, but it was stretchable and comfortable, like wearing a suit for a motorcycle. It wasn't heavy at all. They explained to me that the suit is made of smart clothing. The pads on the suit were the systems. It contains a haptic feedback system that gives you a sense of touch using electrical shocks. The suit also contains a motion capture system using mocap sensors that makes it possible to transmit data of your movement to, for example, a VR application, making full body tracking possible. There is also a temperature control system, making it possible to feel heat and cold sensations. Unfortunately, the demo application wasn't working entirely for me, so the two things I could feel was the haptic feedback system and the motion capture control. However, I could not feel the temperature. The first thing they had me do was calibrating the suit on my body. Using the software, they could adjust what I felt, and they could adjust the strength of it, so they could make it stronger if I didn't feel anything. What they did was they turned on a simulation of raindrops, which kind of felt like 1,000 electrical shocks on my arms that really felt like raindrops. At first, I didn't feel anything until they upped the strength from 10% to like 50%. You can even go all the way to 100%, but they told me that could hurt the person too. But that really depends on the individual. After some calibrating, I went into a VR demo. I could see my own body avatar and see the motion capture working, which worked really well. And then there was an application which contained all kinds of different sensors that I could activate. The first thing I did was grab a gun and, using a mirrored avatar of myself that was standing a little further away, I could shoot myself. This time it actually felt like a big shockwave going through my hands to my upper part of my arm, and then I could feel it go away. It was simulated well and just so interesting. It was on a pretty strong strength though, so it was a bit intense. The lady who was helping me during the demo said that it could be so strong that some people would kind of fall over like this. Ugh. Unfortunately, before I could try all the sensors, the tracking was lost and I could not go further. The developers over there told me that the suit was not synced up right yet, so they had to go fix it. I wasn't able to try it afterwards since they had many appointments scheduled. Hopefully we'll get another try later on, but overall I am quite surprised and impressed at this technology. However, I wonder how safe it is, because it does sound a little bit dangerous, because you can alter the shockwaves to be very, very strong.
But well, if the Tesla suit ever decides to make this something for the consumer market too, then definitely count us in. We won't mind living on the edge for that. I mean, I think this is just a game changer, but also I think the suit is pretty sexy too. Now, let's move on to Maynes VR. We talked with Marijn, head of marketing of Maynes VR, and we are going to let him explain the glove.
Okay, maybe you can tell me a little bit about what you do at Maynes VR.
Yeah, at Maynes VR we make data gloves. So we really want people to be able to use their hands in virtual reality in a very natural way. So behind us you can see one of someone trying out the demo, and she can just in our demo, she can just fix the machine using her hands in a natural way.
Okay, and how does the technique work? I'm seeing a 5 tracker on the gloves.
Yeah. It's only so I will just pick a glove right here. So in the glove there is a sensor which captures all of the data from the fingers. There are some more sensors in here. For the positional tracking we use the 5 tracker system in this case, but it can also be used with any other tracking system such as Vicon or OptiTrack, which are quite expensive, but they can be used with our gloves. It does have a vibrational motor inside which gives you some tactile feedback, for example when you press a button or you pick something up. We like to keep it a bit subtle so your brain gets a little cue like, hey, you're pressing a button, you're doing it right, but you're still really feeling immersed in the virtual reality world.
Okay. On the website, I think I saw that you guys are really focused on business to business.
Yeah.
Are you guys also doing something for consumers?
Well, we actually started the company, it was founded by 4 gamers, and what they saw is the virtual reality market is growing, the gaming market is also growing, and we want to play virtual reality with our hands. Very soon, we already noticed that the VR market is not quite ready for that yet, the consumer market, but businesses started pouring money into the VR market. So right now, we are really focused on B2B, but of course, the plan, when the virtual reality market is ready for it, we will be ready for it with our gloves.
Very cool. So how far are you guys now in the production actually?
Yeah, so this is actually the development kit number 2. We've been selling it already for 2 years and we have over 500 clients that are actually already using it in real life use cases, mostly for training and simulation, designing and collaboration, but also motion capturing, for example.
Okay. It looks like really cool technique. I've been following you guys for quite a while, so I'm really curious to try it out in just a bit. But I was wondering, do you guys have like a release date yet or something?
You can already buy it.
You can buy it already, yeah. The dev kit.
As I said, we've already been selling it for 2 years, but it's kind of pricey. The starting price is 2,000 euros. So to have it at home with your headset for gaming, it's not really gonna be a thing.
Oh, it is really expensive. Will it be cheaper for consumers then?
Of course.
I think that's all my questions for now. Can't wait to try it out.
Yes, of course.
Yeah. Thank you for answering the question.
You're welcome.
So trying this glove was exactly how you expect it to be. It had individual finger tracking. I could throw stuff and then I could try and catch stuff. However, catching stuff was quite difficult, unfortunately. But I can already see that this is could be a great product for the consumer market, since I really like the fact that it's already flexible and wireless. So I would definitely like to see a version of this glove for a consumer price. Interestingly, both Sense Glove and Maynes VR are companies based in the Netherlands. Here, before going to VR Days, I did not know that there were so many innovative VR companies based here. So I'm excited for that, and for the future, I really hope to see more and more VR peripherals getting invented here, or anywhere else actually. So what did you all think? Which of these technologies would you buy straight away if it was available already? Let us know down below. I'm curious to hear your thoughts. And well, VR Days is going to be each year, so next year we are definitely going back to check out the developments of these products, but also anything else that is going to be invented this year. So I'm looking forward to that. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Well, thank you for watching. We really love you guys and your support. One special thanks goes to our champions of Patreon. Thank you guys for being there for us. And well, if you want to explore more VR with us, make sure to subscribe down below if you haven't yet already. And I'm Cass from Cass and Cherry VR. We always say VR on. Fall over like this. Ugh. am losing my voice here. I don't usually talk so much unless it's in front of the camera. Yeah.